Hello everyone, Samantha here. I pray all is well with you. Today I want to show the process of me making an affirmation card based on a devotional that I read and a Faith Impressions Bible Journaling with Carrie Sally devotional book. And this is created by Gel Press. It comes with, you know, the gel plates, the devotional, and some information on how, you know, to use the gel plates. So, as you see, I already have some paint here because I did a layout in this book I set aside to make, you know, just to write something down about the devotional. So you can see here, be who God made you to be, because the devotional is based on comparison. So anyway, this paint on this gel plate is left over from when I used this to make the border for this page. So, let me go on to the devotional. Okay, and for those that have not seen previous videos, just to show it what my affirmation cards look like, scripture affirmation, do it based on scripture, I connect it, right? So, these are little cards that I made, and it's just affirming God's word over myself or in my life. And affirmation is like a declaration. So, I'm free to create. I am creative. Right here, I meditate on God's good news. I'm focused on Jesus. I live in love, not fear. Right here, no fear. You are capable of amazing things. You remember, you are powerful. So, it's, you know. And then on the back of them, I put the scriptures that connect with it. So, you know, it's encouraging. That's what I was going to say. It's encouraging. So, anyway. So, comparison is a joy killer. So, I want to read Galatians 6:4 here. I want to read it in the King James Version first. And then I'll read it in this version. So, it reads, but let each one of you test his own work, and then his reason to boast will be in himself alone and not in his neighbor. Yeah, I'm going to read it again. Galatians 6:4. But let each one test his own work, and then his reason to boast will be in himself alone and not in his neighbor. So, a person could study that scripture on their own, because we know we don't take the glory from God. But that scripture is really saying, just don't compare yourself to other people. Don't, you know, look at what someone else do. Test your own work. I like how it's written here. I just don't remember, or perhaps I never read what version this is. And I suppose I could type the whole thing in Google and see how it comes up. And I'll probably find it. So if I do that, I'll put the version, the translation this is in when I upload the video. So again, comparison is a joy killer. Galatians 6:4. Let everyone be sure to do his very best, for then he will have the personal satisfaction of work done well and won't need to compare himself to someone else. Good. So in other words, you know, when you feel good about what you've done, you don't really have to compare yourself to other ones. And I think it's something that all humanity deals with, because it's constantly pushed in our face. Do it like this person. Do it like that. Why didn't you do it like that? That implies, why didn't you do it like me? You know, why didn't you do it like, why did you do it like that? Why you're not like your sister? Why you're not like your brother? Well, I wouldn't have done it like that. There's so many things, and then competitions and different things that we do that are not necessarily always bad. But if a person doesn't have a healthy self-esteem or a healthy sense of self-worth or confidence, you know, it could really like begin to make them fall deeper into the comparison trap or fall into the comparison trap. But thank God for Jesus who helps us, right? So I'm going to read this here. Good old comparison, whether it's intentional or not, the world shoves it in our faces on a daily basis. Magazines shout headlines like, lose 10 pounds in 10 days, because everyone wants to look like the cover model, right? At work, sales are posted so you can see how you did next to your competition for that next promotion. That commercial tells you how much better this new phone is than yours and has a neat and tidy graph showing all the ways your phone is now inferior. And sometimes we feel like, that phone. If you put our life in a neat and tidy graph compared to someone else, we would be seen as lacking, or at least in our eyes, we would. I'm sorry, y'all. It's early. I'm kind of reading kind of wonky. Sorry about that. I'm going to read that again, okay? And sometimes we feel like that phone. If you put our life in a neat and tidy graph compared to someone else, we will be seen as lacking, or at least in our eyes, we would. But ask yourself, do you really want what they have? That model on the cover has an eating disorder so that she can stay as skinny as her manager says she has to be. That guy with the best sales, his wife left him with the kids because she feels replaced by a mistress he calls work. That phone may have a few cool new things, but costs more than your rent and yours is paid for. Maybe the scenarios aren't always truth, but how do you know? Maybe you are comparing yourself to an image that doesn't really exist. It's just that, an image, a mirage, a charade. The same goes for art and creativity. Art is an expression of someone's life. If you haven't lived their life, you can't expect yourself to express through art the same way. You would then be the one creating a charade or mirage. Galatians 6:4 says, "Let everyone be sure to do his very best." That's all that is asked of you, not his best or her best, your own personal best. Does that mean you will never learn from others, use their techniques, or occasionally create something similar to others? Absolutely not. Most great artists were once apprentices to a great master, where they learned the craft by copying the master. They learned what they needed to learn, and then they found their own way, their own style. They didn't stay under the shadow of their masters forever. The same goes for you. In time, you will find your own style. And as you learn techniques and find your way, don't let the thief of comparison steal the joy of the journey. Amen. And this is a gel press kit, and she did a devotional for it, the Bible journal and devotional for it. But you see, a lot of it is geared towards creative expression. But we can apply this in every area of our lives because we express many things in the Lord, and God doesn't want us comparing ourselves to others and, you know, being robbed of the joy of just being who he has made us to be, doing what he tells us to do, saying what he tells us to say, creating what he says to create, going where he says to go. No more comparison trap. Just like, Lord, let me focus on you, do what you've called me to do. And also too, when I see someone has done and it's beautiful, let me celebrate them. Okay? And let me celebrate myself. Like, Lord, thank you. Thank you that you use me too to do beautiful and amazing things too. We are fearfully and wonderfully made, right? One of the things I always saw in the past, like, comparison, comparing yourself to others as, you know, bringing oneself down. But I learned that it can also bring other people down, because the comparison trap is not always, look at them, their work is so much better, they look so much better, they sing so much better, they dance so much better, they do art so much better, they dress so much better, they cook so much better. All the things that the enemy could try to highlight, right? That they do better. But what I realize is that it could be the reverse. I do that better. I am better. They are, look at, theirs is whack. And so now we start bringing other people down. So it could go to both extremes. There's a scripture here that I want to read. And it's 1 Corinthians 10:12 that says, for we dare not make ourselves, 2 Corinthians 10:12. The scripture is 2 Corinthians 10:12. For we dare not make ourselves of the number or compare ourselves with some that commend themselves. But they, measuring themselves by themselves and comparing themselves among themselves, are not wise. And when you get a chance, if you want, read it all the way to verse 18, because I was like, wow, I got so much out of that, those verses this time that I read it. And it made me really see, like, wow, you know, just pray to avoid comparing yourself to others and just do what God has called you to do and not go above that measure that God has given you. Okay, it's like staying within the framework. And it's not limiting. It's just saying, like, I don't need to do anything that God has not called me to do. And that eliminates a lot of stress. Because when we're trying to be like someone else, I'm telling you now, it gets crazy really, really fast. Because if they're a square peg and I'm a circle peg, and we're trying to fit into the same thing, it doesn't fit. So then you end up feeling crazy and you end up feeling stressed out, and then there's no joy. And it's like, no. Last but not least, I wanted to say, I remember one time years ago, my sister gave me some really good advice about singing. And I remember, because I like singing, and I have a beautiful voice. I don't sound like a Mariah Carey or all of them, but I've learned to say I have a beautiful voice, and God tells me to sing to him, and he thinks my voice is beautiful. But God had to bring me to that. God had to bring me to that because I used to try to sing like other people, and it would sound crazy because I couldn't hit those octaves. And my sister would tell me, sing in your own voice. But see, I used to be ashamed of my own. I used to be ashamed of my voice because my voice is not raspy, but it's not like squeaky. Like, I can't explain it. It's like, you know, for some people used to think I was a man on the phone because my voice is a little bit deep. Like, and I would be so upset. And the devil was using that to make me feel ashamed of my voice. But then as I started growing in the Lord began to show me the purpose for my voice. And I'm not, how can I say, no, I'm not a singer, but I noticed like my voice, it has purposes. If I don't have a microphone and I had to preach on a corner, I could preach on a corner because my voice is loud and it has a level of bass that it carries. So I begin to say, Lord, I thank you. You know what you were doing. You know who you created me to be. So God had to teach me to appreciate my voice and not think I had to sound like Whitney Houston or have to sound like this person or have to sound like that person, you know. And I thank God, my sister would encourage me, sing in your own voice. She told me, sing in your own voice. What the voice, it may not be voice for you. It may be something else for you. Write how God tells you to write. Art how God tells you to art. Dress how God tells you to dress. Be who God created you to be. Go where God tells you to go. Even when we look in the Bible, Paul and Peter were not sent to the same person. Imagine if they would have compared themselves. Well, I need to go to the Gentiles because he going to the Gentiles and he going to look better than I. No, no, no. Be who God created you to be. Go where God tells you to go. Do what God tells you to do. Say what God tells you to say. Create what God tells you to create. Right? Because God don't make any junk. We are all fearfully and wonderfully made. So I realize when we tap into and get a hold of and receive and keep within our heart by the power of the Holy Ghost, what God says about us, that comparison trap, I'm serious, we avoid it. And when the enemy whispers it to our ears, well, look at them, we reject it because we don't want it. We don't want any parts of it. The Holy Spirit doesn't even let us have a peace with it. And we're like, wait a minute, I'm not willing to get off track with what God is telling me to follow what he's told someone else. I am not willing to treat myself and my creativity and my assignment from God as nothing. And like God don't know what he's doing. I'm not willing to do that to embrace what God told someone else to do. I pray for them, bless them, celebrate them. But the time is now. And it's always been time. But today, if you're hearing this and you struggling, the time is now to say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, to who you made me to be. Yes, Lord, to do what you told me to do. Yes, Lord, for me to create what you told me to create. To write what you told me to write. To shine for you, Lord. To let your light shine through me, Lord. I will no longer sacrifice it or myself in you by comparing myself to another individual. I'm done with it. And so I thank God. I thank God for his ability to get us there. It's by the power of the Holy Ghost and by him working in our hearts and changing us and conforming us into the image of his dear son. I'm glad Jesus had when he walked in this earth, the presence of mind. I'm about my father's business. I don't know what that person is about, but I know what I'm about. And so I'm about my father's business. That's, you know, that we can declare that. We could declare that. And if we find that, oh my God, I have to say this, but part of me, God, struggles with believing it. Well, God, you are able. I'm not going to fake it until I make it. But I'm faithing it and I made it. I'm speaking, I'm declaring, I'm affirming God's word. So over my life, affirm God's word, declare God's word rather over your life. Make those affirmations in the Lord. So for the rest of this video, I'm just going to go ahead and show the rest of the process because I already started showing it because I noticed that the Lord was going to have me more to say. So I'll be back at the end to do a review of what, I did, how I made the affirmation card. All right. So I'll be back.
It's a blessing to see peace. Up to the sky still, 'cause honestly for the same people life can be so real. I'm amazed by all your strength I am, and I'm grateful you come through, yeah. So I take this time to stop a moment, show my gratitude for you. I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, 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 beautiful. Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Many mighty ships are sailing, many stars are falling down, and I count it as a blessing that you hold me up now. Oh, I can tell that you've been praying. My whole life has turned around, yeah, yeah. And I can't go without saying that I thank God for you all now, yeah, for you. I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, beautiful. Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love, it's beautiful. say, yeah, 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 yeah. Say, yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, I put my lighter in the air for you.
Alright.
See what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through.
Alright.
Put my lighter in the air.
The truth is, you're beautiful.
Beautiful.
Now
put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song.
Alright.
Put your lighter in the air for love.
Oh, you're
it's beautiful. Beautiful.
Let me say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Let me hear say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Listen to see people with their heads up to the sky still. Cause honestly, for the same people, life can be so real. I'm amazed by all your strength, I am. And I'm grateful you come through. So I take this time to stop a moment and show my gratitude for you.
I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful.
Beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful.
Many mighty ships are sinking. Many stars are falling down. And I count it as a blessing that you hold me up now. Oh, I can tell that you've been praying. My whole life has turned around, yeah, yeah. And I can't go without saying that I thank God for you all now, yeah, for you.
I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, beautiful. Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Let me say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Let me hear say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
See what you go through.
Alright.
Put my lighter in the air.
The truth is, you're beautiful.
Beautiful.
Whoa.
Now put your lighter in the air.
Put your lighter in the air.
Everybody singing together, sing a new song.
Alright.
Put your lighter in the air for love.
Oh, you're
it's beautiful. Beautiful.
Let me say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Say, yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Let me hear say, yeah. Say yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Ooh, ah, yeah.
It's a blessing to see people with their heads up to the sky still. Honestly, for the same people, life can be so real. I'm amazed by all your strength, I am. And I'm grateful you
it's time to stop a moment and show my gratitude for you.
I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful,
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 beautiful.
Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Many mighty ships are sinking, many stars are falling down, and I count it as a blessing that you hold me up now. I can tell that you've been praying. My whole life has turned around, yeah, yeah. And I can't go without saying that I thank God for you all now, yeah, for you.
I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful. Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Let me say yeah, 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 yeah. Say yeah, 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 yeah. Let me hear you say yeah, 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 yeah.
See what you go through.
Alright.
Put my lighter in the air.
The truth is you're beautiful.
Beautiful.
Whoa.
Now put your lighter in the air for
us. Put your lighter in the air.
Everybody singing together, sing a new song.
Alright.
Put your lighter in the air for love.
Oh, you're
it's beautiful.
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 Let me say yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Say yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah.
Let me hear you say.
To see people with their heads up to the sky still.
Hello everyone, I'm back, and I'm not gonna go through everything I did because the process is there, but I just want to explain a couple of things. I wrote, I am who God made me. I do God's will, because when I think about comparison trap, I think about it, a person not being able to be who God made them to be and do what God's called them to do when they're in the comparison trap. So that's my affirmation right here. I've put up here that is very important. and I went a step further and said, thanks Lord, on here. I want to put white and black on the card somehow, so that's why I use, oh, that was the wind, sorry y'all. Kind of scared me. That's why I used the tag. So, and on the back, I use another black and white tag. I have made a mistake and put a little bit of red on there, so I just went ahead and did some smudges on it because it helped it not to be so stark. These are some scripture tags that I made on using my Cricut for these cards, because I want to use those or something else that I make similar to label the scripture. So for the subject here, I put no more comparison trap, and then I wrote the scripture here. Then I put a couple of stickers here. Remember, be beautiful, and put this arrow. This is a sticker I got from the Dollar Tree. And this card was already prepped in some way, because it was a piece of mixed media card that I had from something I was doing a while ago. So I only had to do one side. Instead of doing two cards and gluing them together, I decided just to go ahead and just paint on one side, because this cardstock that this was on was very heavy, and that other side was already completely done, so I didn't have to worry about doing one side and the card still being wet and then working on another side, or it being kind of loose, because once you start working with the card, even though you dry it, it's still sort of like tender, the paper, and so that's why I usually use two pieces, so I won't have to wait so long. But because this is very good cardstock that this mixed media background was on already, I was able just to flip it on the side and you know, add some paint and such. And as you see, I had a, if you watch the video, I had a challenging time with the gel plates. I don't know what was going on, but you know, it happens. And so I'm not gonna make a big to do of that. I was a bit frustrated, though, I'm not gonna front, but then I was like, you know what, you already know this, just keep going until you get something that you're okay with. So yeah, so that's it. The scripture here, I wrote Galatians 6:4, let everyone be sure to do his very best, for then he will have the personal satisfaction of work done well and won't need to compare himself to someone. So, and I believe a part of that is being who God made you to be. Do the best that God's called you to do. And, you know, do his will. And, you know, there's no need to compare yourself to anyone else. So that's it. I want to say thanks for watching. Wait, oh yeah, before I close out, let me just go ahead and put this in here. In the event someone ever seen how you can use this. So, okay, so I got this from Staples, and I also got these Project Life cover pages from Staples, $2.99 a pack for 10, and I believe the mini book binder was like $9.99, if I'm not mistaken. I know they have it at the Staples that I go to in Co-op City. I've never seen another Staples with it. That Staples in Co-op City, they sell a lot of art products like stamping and stickers and things of that sort. So I was so surprised when I found that area in Staples, because I see some things in Staples, but not as much as I see at that one. And like Vicky Buten stamp pads, you know, Project Life stuff. So yeah, that's the one in Co-op City Bay Plaza. Yeah, so I just put it in here, and then I put it inside the binder like so. Sorry about the glare. And so there it is. I rather like how it looks in the plastic. Plastic does something for it. And then, you know, if I turn it over, I have that. And so, my hope at some point is to do all of these. Yeah. So, we'll see. Alright, so that's it. I want to say thanks for watching. God bless you. Remember, you are beautiful. God made you. And Jesus loves you. Bye-bye.